Hello guys, it's Nabil here. You are here because you want to downgrade to any unsigned iOS firmware. You are at the right place. As you can see, I am currently running iOS 14.4.1. I will downgrade this iOS version to the iOS 14.3. In this video, I will show you how to downgrade iOS 14 with SHSH Blobs to any unsigned iOS version using Futurerestore. I have explained the whole procedure step by step with very minimum cuts, although they are fast forward. By the end of this video, you will have unsigned iOS version in your device for which you have already saved SHSH Blobs. But why do you need to downgrade iOS firmware with SHSH Blobs? The reason is your device might start working slow or you face any issues after upgrading to the latest iOS firmware. Then you probably want to downgrade back to the previous version. You can go back to the previous iOS firmware with the SHSH Blobs. If you haven't saved the SHSH Blobs for the previous iOS version where you want to downgrade to, you won't be able to downgrade. Let's just start this video. Now we will get all the files ready that are needed to downgrade with SHSH Blobs using Futurerestore. We will download SHSH Blobs. We will download the unsigned iOS IPSW file and download the Futurerestore. Go to this Futurerestore GitHub link. You will find all the links stated in this video in the description below. The Futurerestore developer has clearly stated all the A13 devices are supported, but the compatibility on A10 and below devices is from iOS 14 till iOS 14.5 beta 2. And the compatibility on A11 and above devices is iOS 14.3 till iOS 14.5 beta 2. Pay attention to this note. Some restores to iOS 14.2 have worked on A11 and above devices, but for now, strongly do not recommend iOS 14.2 restore until we look into it. If you want to downgrade to iOS 14.2, it's not recommended. It's better to downgrade to iOS 14.3 instead. Scroll down and click on the version you want to download. I am downgrading on a Mac computer. I will download a Futurerestore for macOS. We need three files to complete this downgrade process. The first is Futurerestore that I have already downloaded. Second file we need is the unsigned iOS firmware on which we want to downgrade to. Now you need to download iOS firmware which you want to downgrade to from IPSW website. Currently, in my case, I am downgrading to iOS 14.3 from iOS 14.4.1. I will download the iOS 14.3 unsigned IPSW file. Go to this ipsw.me website. Click on the device for which you want to download iOS firmware for. Let's select the iPhone 7 GSM for me. As you can see, these are the currently signed versions. If you haven't saved the blobs for these ones, go and do that. I will put a link into the video's description and up in the cards how to save SHSH blobs for the signed versions. Now click on the unsigned iOS version. From here you can download the file. I already have downloaded, so I will just cancel it. Now finally, we need to download the SHSH blob for the version we want to downgrade to. But for that, we need ECID for our device. If you are on the lower Mac version than macOS Catalina, you can simply get the ECID number from the iTunes. Open iTunes and click twice on the serial number. It will reveal the ECID number. But if you are on a macOS Catalina and above, the method to get the ECID number is little different. First of all, you need to put your device into the DFU mode. Then you will be able to extract the ECID number on Mac OS Catalina and above. I am showing you how you can do that. For my iPhone 7, I will just press and hold both power button and volume down button. I will release the power button after 4 seconds and keep holding the volume down button. This will put my device into the DFU mode. And you will see a pop-up window on your computer screen once your device enters into a DFU mode, as you can see on my computer. This window is stating my device is in the recovery mode. So now I can get the ECID number of my device. Click on the search tab and search here for the system information. Open this window. Click on the USB from the left list, and here you can see the EC ID number. Double click on it and copy it. After you have copied the EC ID number, go back to the TSS server website and paste the EC ID number here. You need to put that in the retrieve section. Click on the open link. This will show you all the iOS versions for which you have saved the SHSH blob. Click on the iOS version you want to download SHSH blobs for. I will click on the iOS 14.3. Click here to download the SHSH blob. I have already downloaded it. I will just cancel it. After you have downloaded all the required files, now we will start the process to downgrade to unsigned iOS firmware using Futurerestore. First of all, take the complete backup of your device, because all of your device's data will be wiped out during this downgrading process with Futurerestore, and you will have a stock iOS version running on your iPhone as you get on a new iPhone. Secondly, turn off Find My iPhone and log out your iTunes and iCloud account on your device. These are the necessary steps before you start to downgrade iPhone with SHSH blob. Get the generator value from the downloaded SHSH blob. Open the downloaded SHSH blob file with the text editor. Press Command and F for generator. Here you can see the generator value. This is the value you need to set in your device first. This is the crucial step. The steps are different to set the generator value with different jailbreak applications. When I am recording this video, I am currently on iOS 14.4.1 and I am currently jailbroken with checkerin jailbreak, because checkerin jailbreak is the only jailbreak for iOS 14.4. I will put a link in the description for how to set a generator value using the other jailbreaks. If you are jailbroken using checkerin jailbreak, please continue watching this video. How you can jailbreak with the checkerin jailbreak, I will put its link up in the cards and in the description below. You can jailbreak using checkerin jailbreak. After you have got the generator value to set, open the Safari browser and go to this website. hello-michael.github.io/en_us/. You need to write this US in the capitals, otherwise you will get an error. You will find the link below in the description as well. Tap on add it to CDA or add it to Cilio, depending on which package manager you have. Tap on the install the source and it will install it in your package manager. Now tap on continue to source. Now we need to download two things. First, the generator auto setter. Go to G section and click on generator auto setter. Click on the install button. Now here, instead of clicking the confirm, tap on continue queuing. This way we can download multiple tweaks at the same time. Go to the search bar and search for new term. Tap on the new term 2 and install this tweak. Tap on confirm. This will download both of the things in your device. Hello guys, if you have made this far in this video, hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel for more iOS related videos. Now open the new term, type SU and hit done. Now type the password. The password is Alpine. You can see that on your screen as well. Now type set generator. This will set the generator value to 0x16x1. But if your generator value is different than 0x16x1, then type set generator space type the generator value and hit the return. As the generator value is set, go back to your computer, open the terminal now. Go to your finder, go to go and click on utilities. In this folder you will find the terminal. Now before you continue, here you need to connect your device to your computer. And your computer is connected to the Wi-Fi network because the process will download a few files. First of all, extract the Futurerestore file and drag and drop it to the terminal. After that, make sure there is a space. Now type dash T, hit the space button, then drag and drop the SHSH blobs file. Then again, make sure there is a space at the end. Now type double dash latest dash SEP. Again, press the spacebar after that and type double dash latest dash band. After you have written these two commands, hit the space button at the end. Then drag and drop the IPSW file. Now before you hit the enter button, copy these commands. Because during the process, we will have to write all these commands again. Because during the process, entering your device into recovery mode doesn't get recognized. So we will have to then type all these commands again and hit enter. I will show you that if you are doing it for the first time, after hitting the enter, you will see a warning stating Futurerestore cannot be opened because the developer cannot be verified. Click on the cancel, go to search and type the system preferences, open it, go to security and privacy, click on this log button, type in your computer's password, go to the general and click on allow anyway. Then again click on the log button to save the settings. Now paste the commands again and hit the enter button. Click on open in the pop-up. Now this will start the process. This is a long process to downgrade to unsigned iOS firmware using Futurerestore. I have made very less cuts in this video so you can see what is exactly happening. Although I have applied many fast forwards in this video, I will put a sound on that as well so you can recognize the video is being fast forward. Hello guys, if you have made this far in this video, hit the like button, also subscribe to my channel for more iOS related videos. Now it's entering in the recovery mode. You will see your device entering in the recovery mode as well. As you can see, as I stated earlier, you will see a message unable to place device into recovery mode from normal mode. However, you will see your device is in the recovery mode. Here we need to put the commands again. Paste the commands we copied earlier and hit the enter. As you can see, now it's downloading the SEP. Now accepting the file system from iPSW is specified. Now, after extracting file system from iPSW, if you see a green screen on your device, that means you are going good. You will also see a warning on your computer. Setting BG color to green, if you don't see a green screen, then your device didn't boot IBEC correctly. Now here, keep in mind, if you see this error, unable to receive message from FDR, do not panic. This will go further. You can see multiple errors like this in a row. Don't do anything. This will go further. Now it's sending the file system after it's validated. Now this will take a little while. I am just fast forwarding it. As you have seen, I am making no cuts. The whole process is in front of you. You need to be patient. I am just fast forwarding it. You will see the progress on your device's screen as well. Now it's verifying the restore after the file system is sent. Hey guys, as you can see on the computer screen, the status is restore finished and below you can see restoring succeeded. The restore is successfully done. If you have done the restore, leave a comment below. After that, your device will take a little bit of time setting up. Once you see the hello screen, just set up your device. Now I will just quickly set up my device and show you I have downgraded it to unsigned iOS 14.3 version from iOS 14.4.1 successfully using SHSH Blobs with Futurerestore. As the setup is completed, now I will show you on which iOS version I am. I will just go into the settings, general, about section, and here you can see I am on iOS 14.3 from iOS 14.4.1. The downgrade process has been successful. If you have successfully downgraded, let others know below. Also hit the like button, also the subscribe button. Thank you for watching.